Okay, does anything happen during the night? Because I kind of want to move this fucking thing along. No.
The night is quiet.
Good.
Except for some...
And full of slapping.
Yeah, whatever you want to do in your own downtime, that's your business.
Yes. No slapping.
In that case, do I get awoken at the correct time?
You are awoken at the requested hour, yes.
Good. I will perform my morning ablutions very quickly and sit down to have breakfast.
Okay. There is a porridge prepared for you.
Is it poisoned?
I don't care about... I don't care at this time.
Plus, I'm tired.
It's hot and filling.
Yeah, works. That's fine enough.
Is it too hot? Or is it too cold? Or just right?
Shut up.
Sorry.
Me and some real bears.
Right, Pure, are you up? I guess so. Since you should have been awoken at the same time.
I got slapped awoken, apparently.
Is anyone else up at this time?
Just I'm up outside the shrine.
What? Say again?
I'm up standing guard at the shrine.
Okay, so after my... After breakfast is concluded, I bring that paper with the positions and walk over to the shrine, hand it over to you, and walk in to retrieve my hat, because I will need that for traveling. Don't want to get sunburned.
Wow.
It's a delicate skin. Mm.
Well, listen, I'm a fucking wimpy courtier. What do you expect?
I compare the sheet of paper against the board and realize that everything's upside down.
God damn it.
Just holding up
a we have to turn the board around. It doesn't work.
Yep, it seems untouched.
Right. I collect my hat and walk over back to the inn or wherever the stable is and get the horses and lead them over to the hut to where the prisoner is.
Okay.
No, the unslapped prisoner. Thanks, Obama.
Pure, are you with me?
Yes.
Okay, good. Is the prisoner still there?
The prisoner is still there.
Is the rat still there?
Well, I don't care about the rat. let's load up this fucking prisoner on this fucking horse and get out of this loony fucking village.
Is that what you fucking precisely say to me?
Nutters. No. This is internal dialogue. let's load up the prisoner and start riding. We have a long day ahead of us.
So you're seriously starting to regret your choice of companions, are you?
It's not the game. It's not the stuff that happens in game. It's the stuff that happens out of character. That's fucking.
Fuck. Well, technically speaking, the slapping did happen in game. Just saying.
Shut up about it.
Okay, right. So we put the prisoner on a horse.
Make sure he's tied and so on and so on, so he doesn't fuck off anywhere. Make sure I have the emerald seal with me.
Okay.
And we start riding towards Crane territory.
It's probably a very good idea you have Pure with you instead of me, because I can't run after anyone. If you start running, you're just going to escape.
And thus the party was split.
Well, if he starts running, my initiative is so fast, I could probably kill him before he runs away.
Or just chop his leg off. No.
Aren't his feet still bound?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, he ain't running.
So well, you basically have him lying over the horse.
Yeah, we have him lying over the horse.
Yeah.
Okay. That's very uncomfortable when you're riding.
Well, that's his problem.
Well, he's going to die when he gets
there. I was going to say, it's not like...
Wait, didn't these guys come in on horses?
No, they walked in.
No, they walked in.
They walked in, okay.
They're not fancy, Ronin.
Yeah, exactly. I was confused there for a little bit. I'm not even sure this guy could ride if he wanted to.
Well, not unless you untied him.
Uh-huh. Well, we're not going to gallop anyway, because the horses can't take a whole fucking day of galloping, so, you know. just a canter. Whatever the speed the horses can take.
You'd probably alternate if you're going to be traveling all day, sort of, you know, a couple of miles at the canter and then a couple of miles at the walk, and just alternate between them back and forth.
Yeah. Every time we find water, just pause and let the horses drink and so on.
Yeah. I mean, most samurai would have an idea of how to take care of a horse in traveling.
Yeah, yeah. It's not very difficult. I know how to do that in real life.
Yeah, I'll just buy a horse.
So.
Right, so travel. Over to you guys.
Yeah. Back to the inn. Who's doing what?
Finishing breakfast, I guess.
I'm still standing guard waiting to be relieved and go and have breakfast.
I guess I'm also having breakfast then.
We'll switch guard duties.
Yeah. Switching guard duties at meals is probably going to be the way forward, I think. That way we're going to allow everyone to basically... We can probably fit in like 5 schedules then a day.
Is anybody going to sleep during the day?
No.
I don't think I'll need to sleep during the day, but I'll probably need an early night again.
Okay. Just try and get an idea of how much sleep you're going to get during the day or over the course of the 24 hours. And
I mean, I guess I'll go for a couple of hours nap after I'm relieved, and then I'll go have breakfast, then I'll have a nap.
I'm thinking, would I still be asleep on just like for 3 hours extra, since, you know?
Well, if you weren't being woken up before dawn, then
I probably would have told you to take an extra few hours sleep.
Yeah, so I'll just be sleeping still. Igor's just sitting there eating by himself.
Yeah. Yeah, hang on 1 second.
Your adoptive family are all like, what's he doing? Why is he still in bed?
Should we slap him?
What was that?
Clown car.
That was a truck or a bus or something? I didn't quite catch it.
I was earlier trying to find an appropriate image for a chip slapping routine. I'm trying to see if there was anything good from the "why don't I slap your shit" meme, but this sadly wasn't.
Of course there's a meme about something like that.
And there was also a menacing pigeon I found.
Menacing pigeon.
Menacing pigeons aside, a little bit, probably an hour or so after dawn, your two guests arise. The servant's already up and gotten breakfast sorted for them. They take care of what they need to, then they head out to start the morning play.
I'll be watching that since everyone else is sleeping or, you know, slapping.
Okay, give me... Whoever's on guard can give me a perception roll for the morning.
Also, does Ego actually have to make an additional roll to try and give a shit about the crane dying?
That's entirely optional.
Why would I? I rolled 12.
Yeah.
Well, thoroughly bored.
Oh, seems quiet.
More of a night.
Occasional click of pieces being set onto the board.
It's a roller coaster, I know.
Akita Fujimura's servant bringing occasional cups of tea for his master. Around lunchtime, he heads off to the inn to get the food prepared for them. They break at lunchtime for food. Are you swapping for somebody else taking guard duty?
Because that would be me.
Okay. They come back after they've eaten. You can give me a perception roll, see if anything crops up.
Uh, 53.
Holy shit. Oh, sorry,
perception roll. Right, that's not... I did the whole notice thing.
Well, yeah, that's... It's notice is the emphasis you would use for it.
I just okay, then.
It's just that none of us have notice except for you and Eldest.
All right, so 53 then.
Okay. You've been watching those pigeons, and they seem to be getting closer to the shrine.
God damn it.
No, I'm not going to turn into pure. I'm already paranoid enough already.
Maybe I should slap the pigeons.
Slap.
I guess I've probably got back up. You know,
can I ready my slapping arms as a free action?
Okay, I'm going to guess that I got up before lunch was served, and I would like to spend the late morning and early afternoon continuing to question random peasants and the innkeeper and the headman, whoever that I can find, basically, about the samurai, if there's any other information that they haven't already given me.
Most of the peasants are going to be working in the fields around the village.
I don't care, they can stop what they're doing.
Okay. I'm just telling you, you're going to be wading up to your knees in water if you want to talk to them.
Okay, I will go commando.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh. Okay, Harry, I just want to ask. Is this going to turn into a whole thing about the pigeons actually being the main menace this whole time?
Only if they're Shadowlands pigeons.
Okay.
God damn it.
Do the pigeons have glowing red eyes?
You haven't seen them at night, so you don't know.
Does Chief have glowing red eyes at night? God damn it, Chief.
Okay, well, I guess the way that I'd be questioning, I'd go out to the fields, but I wouldn't be going into the actual the water section or anything. So I'd just be shouting from the side, "You up here now?" Just literally picking people at random.
Okay.
Asking them questions.
You're not able to get very much information. I mean, none of them know first names of the samurai. Some of them have never even seen them. The children haven't seen them.
I don't bother asking the kids. Anyone younger than 15 probably has no idea.
To be honest, anybody younger than about 20 might not even remember them being here the last time. They can give you little bits and pieces of information, but nothing that's really helpful in identifying them. You know, it's things like they're tall, they're loud, they wear swords.
Yeah.
Well, yes, that is a crab.
Okay, then. I am going to go away from the farms, try and find a nice piece of calm, no peasants around or anything area. And I'm going to commune with a spirit.
Okay.
Do the pigeons start to mess around him? Mentally.
Are you going to try sense first, or just go straight to commune?
I guess I should sense first, just to see. Oh, sense is for a specific type, isn't it? So.
Let me double check.
Yeah, we went over this last time. I sense for a specific type of element, and then it's like I turn things around and go, is there anything else around?
Oh yeah, you have to be careful what kind of element you summon.
Yes, because, for example, summoning my little fire elemental would not be good because I have to sacrifice something.
Well, you'd be sacrificing whatever building you're in.
Yeah, like, hey, see that hut over there? Tell me what I want, you can have it.
I was just thinking that Harry window or the different elements be able to answer differently.
If you think about it, the best one, probably the sense for at this point, would be water. Because if the village has been surrounded by the paddy fields, you know, for as long as it's been here,
it might be able to show me.
It would be able to show you pictures of those samurai.
Yes. Yes, okay, yeah, I'm gonna sense for a water spirit then. So my ring on water is 2. And my mastery level is only 1, so rolling 3.
Uh-huh.
3K2.
Uh-huh.
9.
Not enough, I'm afraid. You're not able to sense any water kami around.
Damn.
Well.
Fire wouldn't be any good. Earth. How does earth? Yeah. Earth a blunt, uninterested in the behavior of mortals. Poor understanding of emotion. Overly focused on obscure details, such as the color of a piece of clothing or the weight of a horse.
They also don't have a great sense of time.
Yeah. Okay, I'll be frustrated again and I'll just leave it at that. If anything, since it's now around lunchtime, is the drunk showing up?
He hasn't done.
Okay then. I guess I'll stop by the shrine and I'll ask. What's your name again, Igor?
Just Hida.
Yeah, I'll ask Hida if whereabouts did you throw that drunk yesterday?
His house.
Oh God! Do you actually forget to unlock the house again?
Can you point out which one it was?
I point to the house.
I go to the drunk's house.
Okay.
And I knock on the door, or whatever the appropriate way that would be, but for being polite, rather than just barging in.
Okay. You knock on the door. There's no response.
Okay. They open the door.
Hut's empty.
Uh-oh.
Just abandoned empty, or it's been packed up?
You don't think it's been abandoned, it's just there's nobody here.
He'll be working in the rice fields.
Yeah, maybe he couldn't get alcohol today.
Or maybe he realizes that he was acting an idiot in front of samurai and is staying as far away as possible.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, well, I suspect that the elements are working against me, and right, okay, fine, I'll wait for them to show up then.
Oh, and the next time you can use your void points to increase your roll, right?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but for something like that, I just didn't see the use.
And can you actually do that however many times you want, as long as you have points for it, Harry?
It was 1 point per roll, right? We looked it up.
I think it's 1 point. Yeah, you can. Yeah.
And it adds 1K1, right?
Yeah, that's an additional dice. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Yeah, you can add. Can you add that, like, however many times you want, or just once?
No, once per roll.
Normally, once per roll.
Okay.
The only time I would probably allow more than one to be used was if it was somebody using up multiple to reduce damage and keep themselves alive.
Okay.
If it comes down to a choice of, you know, dying or blowing all your void, I'd probably, you know, let you away with it in that case.
What, yeah, just about... wondering if the whole once per roll was only during combat, or if that also applied to social, you know, social situations.
Any dice roll.
Okay.
Yeah, what about situations where that is applied to an item? Because, for example, actually, so the katana has a special note on it, which is spend one void point to get a 1k1 bonus. Mm-hmm. Could you potentially then spend two void points for that? Because part of it comes along with the weapon, and then one is spending
it's
additional.
Yeah, it's two different things.
Okay. Right, okay. Yeah, I kind of get the feeling from the way that Harry's been describing this is that even if I was able to get a water element, it would literally just show me two samurai arriving and then leaving. Because the water element's probably not going to know about what the hell they do inside the inn.
No, it can only show you what it sees.
Yeah. So it's probably not going to give me any more information than I currently have.
Well, and it could have shown us what they looked like when they're alive.
Yeah, when you ride off and you come in. I mean,
or maybe what happened to them.
Exactly.
If they died outside, of course.
I don't think they died outside if they're riding off. They rode off and they died out there somewhere.
But yeah, I mean, outside, as in, you know, outdoors.
But then again, a water spirit from around here wouldn't know that.
No, oh, right.
Oh, bored now. Okay, what's up?
Weather! Yeah, that's all I really wanted to do.
Okay.
Are the pigeons still drawn closer? I need to make a new notice check to see if they're drawn closer.
No, they seem to have settled on the roof of the building. The roof of the
shrine. God damn it. That's evil bastards.
It's not an open roof anymore, though, so...
Nope, not at the moment.
And hopefully not for the foreseeable future.
That comment worries me. Not for the moment.
Depends how many pigeons land on it. Sack it.
You know, it's a wooden shrine. They're flammable. Things happen. No, the shrine has been repaired, so there's nowhere the pigeons can kind of poke their heads through.
So I guess we just move on to the next thing that happens.
Yeah. or we smash cut over to our traveling companions.
Yeah, I took the opportunity to actually get some food.
Oh, God. I'm jealous of you now. I really should have done that myself.
Yes, you should have.
Should have. So,
Harry.
The day passes relatively quiet for those on the road. It's, you know, horseback travel. It's a quiet area. There's not really that much you can say or do. The prisoner complains frequently.
Could slap him.
Oh, no. He's a prisoner.
But, you know, that's kind of to be expected. You're not particularly worried by his complaints.
Nope.
Don't just cut his tongue out.
Well, no.
No.
He won't get information out of him.
Oh, yeah, true.
So you don't threaten with turning the horses around if he doesn't stop complaining?
No. I'm going to go back to the spooky village.
Going back to the slapping chip? Actually, that probably would be a good threat.
No, not going to say that.
Oh, poor you.
So, getting on towards maybe an hour or so from sunset, you see ahead lights of the town that you're heading for. another half hour's riding, perhaps, you reach it.
Wait, sunset? You specifically said previously that you can get to this town and back inside of a day.
On a horseback.
Yeah, but you can't exactly push full speed with this guy draped over a horse.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah, but you can't exactly push full speed
with
any horse for half a fucking day.
Possibly.
It's just the way that it was described and the way I wrote it down.
The nearest
town is a few hours away on horseback, there and back in a day.
I don't care, really. Whatever.
Probably said a day. It was a day away. But if you wrote it down, I guess.
It doesn't really matter.
No, it's how I wrote it down. I may have misunderstood.
It's okay. We'll say it takes about 6-7 hours each way.
Yeah, that's sort of what I was expecting. You know, it would be a long day, but it would still be...
Okay.
Yeah, so it's basically just after lunch, possibly, question mark?
Yeah, we'll say early afternoon.
Yeah. Okay.
I've got a phone ringing here.
Ah. I was wondering who that was.
I'm going to get a drink refill.
So, Edge, I'm actually wondering, have you actually been able to successfully cast a spell yet that didn't come with manual?
I summoned that spirit in the first episode.
That's true,
first
yeah.
session.
That is true.
The wind spirit, which then gusts around the house.
Ineffectually.
No. The going to play in the house was its reward for giving me information.
Ah. So did you actually...
Despite the fact that it didn't really help me.
Yeah. Another question. Did you actually put ice in that fucking drink?
Yes.
Jeez. I don't have everything cool.
It's a cocktail. It's supposed to be served cool.
Yeah, that's what I mean. So I have my gin in my freezer and all the other stuff in my fridge.
Oh yeah, the drink's been in the fridge as well.
So why do you need ice?
Bonus.
Dilution.
Because his eye is cold.
That's why to make the perfect dry martini, you don't use crushed ice. You use whole cubes to dilute the alcohol as little as possible during cooling. To which I say, why not just have everything cold from the fucking start?
I would actually, going back to what Chip was asking, I would say that I would have successfully summoned a spirit, or I would have successfully summoned wind last time if it hadn't been for the raises. It was the raises that made me lose that.
Oh, I mean, raises.
So why did you have?
Because I was trying to do like two raises, which meant the target number increased by 20. It was basically, I rolled crap for a start, but I basically still needed to get an above 3/4 roll, I think, pretty much. I'm still waiting for the chance to put fire around Igor, though.
Well, I guess for that to happen, we actually have to start fighting real enemies instead of all these fucking ghosts.
Not necessarily. I could just go and put a fire shield around him anyway, but...
Oh, right.
What would be the context?
We could use him as a lantern.
It's only valid for a minute.
We could make someone crap their pants. No. If someone sees a very big crab coming towards him on fire...
Yeah.
Well, first I'm gonna, cancel out the place where the spell came from. Then I'll go to the target.
Okay, who set the crab on fire while I wasn't watching?
It's the main shugenja in the corner. I disarmed him. Sorry.
Yes, he cast counter spell with his tetsubo.
Counter spell to the face.
Well, it never works.
You?
Okay, so you arrive in the Korean town. Gate guards are staring at this procession coming closer. When you get there, they step forward. Papers.
I calmly hand them over.
The real ones, not the fake one.
I don't have fake ones.
I mean, you've got the jade thing, haven't you?
Yeah, I don't. That will. I'll hand over to someone of fucking rank.
Yes, he's not going to start flashing that now.
I've got this. Look, everyone, I've got this.
Where was it that you came from?
Rotten Barrow.
What? Wait.
No.
What do you mean? Who?
The guard's asking you where you've come from originally.
Originally?
My mom.
I hail from blah.
Well, yeah, I'm fucking from the Kitsuki family, from Dragon Clan lands. Should say in my fucking papers, doesn't it?
Insert appropriate town here.
Yeah.
I like how he starts swearing at the guard.
No, I'm just confused. What's in these papers?
Travel papers are basically an authorization allowing you to go from point A to point B.
It doesn't identify me in any way?
No, it
yes,
does.
Yes, but you're coming to point C now.
Ah, I've come to point C. Oh.
Yeah.
Well, you probably would have come through Korean territory. So...
Oh, yeah.
We would have come through this town, I expect.
Are you on the return leg is kind of the impression going on here.
Ah. No. This is detour. Since we discovered two Ronin in possession of the emerald.
The seal of an emerald magistrate.
The seal of an emerald magistrate, yeah, that was it. One of them is dead. The other, I point to the horse behind me, is our prisoner. And after questioning him, I discovered that he killed a crane magistrate to obtain the jade seal. he has confessed to the murder of a crane samurai, a crane magistrate, and I'm bringing him to you so that you can further question him and mete out justice.
The gunsel bows towards you, snaps his fingers towards one of the other guards. Take this vermin, throw him in jail. We will have to take down the details of what you have told us, if you would be so kind as to join me in here.
Of course.
So, takes you into a little guardhouse, fills in some forms, just basically gets the story from both of you. Whenever you produce the seal of the Jade Magistrate, Emerald Magistrate, yeah, that's pretty much a done deal at that point. That's all the evidence that they really need.
Yeah. So, as we may we enter town, we would like to, while we're here, acquire some supplies.
Of course.
Thank you. Will you take? Well, rather, since I'm still holding on to the Emerald Seal.
That. So the guards would take that and pass it along to one of their own magistrates.
Yeah, okay. Because I was basically just trying to angle who I should deliver this to.
You've delivered it to the Crane Guards. The Crane Guards will deliver it to the Crane Magistrate. The Crane Magistrate will escalate from there.
Right. Oh, well. I was just going to try... I was going to try and rub some shoulders with some high-ups, but hey.
Hey, don't try to min-max this.
That's my job.
Yeah, that's it. Well, in that case, please find out what you can from this criminal, and I wish you luck finding the remains of your slain magistrate.
The criminal will be dealt with accordingly.
I nod, and yeah, bid him goodbye, and let's enter town. Not sure how big this is, but...
A few thousand people.
Hmm.
Reasonable-sized town. Certainly enough that you'll be able to get anything that you're after. At least right. For basic supplies.
Yeah. Okay, so... my goal here is basically to get... as you say, basic supplies for... our party and our guests, and by basic supplies I mean basic in a civilized part of the country and not in a peasant village. So good quality rice, fresh vegetables, dried fish, you know, all that kind of provisions basically. Food. Also, I need to buy more paper. Because if I'm going to be writing down that fucking score every day, it's going to end quickly.
Okay.
Are you using both sides of the paper?
What?
Make sure you use both sides of the paper.
Yeah, I can use both sides, and I can also wipe my ass with it after both sides are used. You know, just completely recycle everything.
One after the other, not the other way around.
Mm-hmm. I just said I would wipe after both sides have been used. What the fuck do you take me for?
At this point, we're not sure.
Hey!
That'd be rough. I could have called you a crab.
True.
It's Crane who just takes tea from people. Yells at pigeons. Ooh, crap, so uncivilized. Fucking pigeons! Give me that tea!
Let me link that in your hand earlier.
Yeah, you could roll to intimidate the pigeons. It's up to you.
Yeah, exactly. Scowl at them. I'm on to you.
And we'll also see the pigeons actually win that roll.
Yeah.
Like just find Pure cowering in the corner with pigeons around him.
I have had kind of something along those lines happen in the previous game. It was an Abyssal Exalted game. The player could see through the eyes of his familiar, only it was kind of a hate-hate relationship between the two. Roll a willpower check, and he just rolled a complete botch. Found himself in another room wondering how he'd gotten there.
Wow.
It was a fun game. So, let's see. Yeah, it takes probably about an hour to get everything that you need in the town.
Yeah, we do have a spare horse, so we can use that for...
Yeah.
Great. How much do I need to erase from my coin purse?
Most of the stuff you're after is fairly basic. I say it's about 2 boo.
How many boo in a koku then?
5.
5, okay.
You have 5 silver boo in a koku and 20 copper zany in a boo.
Okay. Cool. Well, that's fine. So I guess how long do we have supplies? I'm guessing a lot of this stuff. The fish is dried, so that's fine. The rice is okay. Fresh veggies will hold for a few days. You know, basically, I'm just trying to get maybe a week's supply. That's kind of a lot of food. A week's supply for 7 people.
Sounds like Pure is already eating into your rations.
Yeah.
if our rations include bread and cheese, then sure.
Bear in mind, the way that the currency works is that... What is it? Is it 1 boo is equal to a year's worth of food?
1 koku.
Okay, 1 koku is a year's worth.
Yeah, but it is not like you don't drop a koku down and get a year's worth of food. It's just
obviously.
Like... You know, it's just indicated like that at one point, but it's inflated how much it, so...
Yeah, it's enough rice to support 1 person.
For a year.
Family of peasants.
Yeah. Enough rice to support 1 year, and... that's basically rice only.
So what you're saying is that if I dropped a koku on the ground, I could watch the peasants claw themselves to death just to get it.
Yeah.
For science, of course.
They might not know what a koku is. They might never have seen one before.
Well, they make their own rice, right?
They probably wouldn't have. I mean, a village's taxes for the year could be like a handful of koku.
Yeah. And a koku is also a measure of rice volume or weight. I don't even remember.
Mm-hmm. It's derived from a real thing.
Yeah. It's not just a coin. It's actually a weight or a volume. I don't remember which. So it's a physical quantity of rice. So having gathered or acquired all that stuff, I guess. What time is it? Do we make... Well, I guess we could make it back before midnight.
I presume it's probably around the evening now, since we finished gathering supplies and dealing with our...
Well, okay, wait. In that case, if we want to stay here for the night, I'm not going to gather supplies until tomorrow. So basically it's a question of whether we can get back at a reasonable time tonight, or...
Well, you arrived at around a bit later than midday, right?
Yeah.
It's kind of like early afternoon.
So you'll probably be back before like 7, something like that.
No.
That's assuming that it took less than an hour to do everything.
True. About, 8, 9.
So no, I mean this question basically goes to Harry. Well, if we do all the acquisitions and set out, when will we reliably be back?
It would be after dark.
Yeah, that's a given. But before midnight?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's
fine. Probably about 9:10 at night. That's fine. Yeah. So let's. Then just get all the provisions and let's head back.
Tally-ho.
Just to check on Chip's behalf, did the stuff that you bought include his list?
I've never seen a list from Chip.
I didn't have a list. I'm just joking.
Oh, okay, you're joking. Okay, right, fine.
No, I haven't seen any lists. I'm just taking this off the top of my fucking head.
Yeah, wait a minute. When Chip mentioned wanting some stuff, I thought that he legitimately did want some stuff.
Well, I'm telling you that I have to slap you with my bare hands. Is that what you're telling me?
Yes. What?
So you want bare hands now?
Other than the slapping stuff, I thought you legitimately wanted something.
No, not yet.
The time will come.
As I said, I can always go into town later if we need anything.
Yeah.
And try to use my commerce.
Mm.
Which is crap. But it's better than nothing.
Yeah, it's better than non-existent. Besides, I'm samurai, I don't barter.
No, you simply tell the peasant what you want and they tell you how much it costs.
And they rip you off.
Yep.
Special samurai rate.
Yeah, but you're rich.
In comparison to the peasants, yes. Besides which, as samurai, you don't really care that much about money. The money is just a tool to do what you need it to do.
Yeah. It's a fucking RPG. Why would I care about money?
Money.
You never played D&D.
Yeah.
Well, I have played D&D, but I didn't care about money there either.
Even in D&D.
Get out.
Okay, so who's on the afternoon shift back in the village?
I guess it'll be the next person in line. Or is it
probably me again then.
Okay, so the only thing...
Wait, let me just check. So, Igor took over for the morning.
Mm-hmm.
And then, Chip, did you take over again?
Yeah, so that's still me then. Afternoon, that's still me.
Yeah, okay, so yeah, after... Yeah, so lunch to dinner would be Chip then.
Yeah.
Okay, so, again, relatively quiet afternoon. There's a handful of moves been played. Crayons drinking tea. Some polite conversation.
Pigeons moving in.
Pigeons bugger off again.
Oh.
That's where they came from. We've got all the information. The strike is gone.
Yeah, that was just a recce flight. Yes. When you see them coming over in formation, then you know what the problem
is. Watch the Valkyrie shot plane. Shit!
Yeah.
Yeah. No. And you hear Tora, Tora, Tora.
Okay, okay.
So... Evening meal. People are back in the inn. Who's in the inn at the moment?
I will be.
Probably me as well. Getting something to eat before my shift.
Trying to drown your disappointment in your inability to cast spells.
Okay, you can give me another perception.
Those of us in the inn.
Sorry?
Are those of us in the inn give perception?
Those of you in the inn, yeah.
14.
Perception. 16.
You think that Kikita-san looks a little bit worse than yesterday?
Oh, fantastic.
Oh, God. He's going to die on us.
Yep.
And we can't actually
not
help
horribly
him?
So, but just
worsening.
Okay. Etiquette check. Since I am actually the priest, can I literally just go up to him and say, I want to give you a physical sort of thing?
Is there actually anything like a doctor's order? I don't think so.
No.
I mean, you can say that, you know, he looks a little unwell to your practiced eye. Is there anything you can do for him?
Okay, yep, I word it like that.
But I mean, if he says no, then
Yeah, I can't really insist.
You're fucked.
I think you have to make a courtier roll, maybe?
I don't have any sort of...
Oh.
I literally have one level in etiquette, and that's just about all my social skills.
So this is walking up to him going like, "Hey, dear, I'm a doctor."
No, this is going up going, "You look like crap. I can help you out."
I can make you look like less like crap.
Yeah.
You lay down on the table and show me your tongue.
Yeah. And just take out a saw.
I'm basically a step above checking his symptoms on the internet and basically being told that he has cancer. But I'm a step above that.
Oh, that's paranoia.
Which is the thing, there's
actually
a word for that.
Well, Crane looks like shit.
Don't care. Yeah,
yeah,
yeah, yeah.
You guys,
I will go up to him and I say, I've dealt with a few sick people in my time.
Wow.
You kind of look like one.
Wow, okay.
But much kinder.
No, I assure you I'm quite all right.
See, this is what I hate about these people. You can't help them.
Yeah, they're
okay,
basically
yeah.
Wealthy.
Okay,
okay,
if you change your mind, then...
He's not going to change his mind.
I will be fine. So, he's a little bit less talkative over the course of the meal. He has his food. Doesn't finish it, you notice. And then retires early.
Does anyone else in the party have medicine and diseases?
No. Well, I have diseases.
Chip probably has disease.
I don't even know about that. What Chip does in his private time is Chip's business.
With a basic medicine check, is there like any way that before I go and like relieve Chip, could I sort of like quickly check his food to see if there is anything? Although no, because it's probably not the food, is it?
Else has had.
It's going to be the tea.
Yeah, because I've been eating the same food as well, yeah. So.
Or it's going to be the ghosts.
Probably the ghosts.
Or maybe, yeah, because he's old.
He's been possessed. He's been possessed by one of the ghosts.
I guess you could try to aim or probe him while he's sleeping. Might be a bit awkward if he wakes up.
Okay, yeah, is a cup of the tea still around?
Oh, no.
God damn it, Pure, what have you started?
I fell for the false flag and it became a real
You just have to do what I did during the first time you played. Just roll with it.
For all we know, this could be slow mercury poison.
You don't see any in here. It's possible that the servant could have left it at the shrine, but it's more likely he would have taken it with him.
Mm, yeah.
You can check the shrine, though.
Also, Pure isn't dead yet, so that's something.
Yeah, but I only drank a little bit of it, whereas...
Give it time. You can only hope.
exactly. Sustained consumption, basically, yeah. Okay, yeah, I don't bother checking anything else then, and I go and relieve Chip so that he can eat.
Okay. Evening passes relatively quietly. Anybody who's in the shrine... Actually, who is in the shrine during the evening?
The evening... Well, okay, so it's either going to have to be... Because the others haven't got back yet...
So Eagle.
Either Eagle's going to have to do a second shift, or I'll do a long shift. And then one of you guys will leave me to like late night, early morning.
Yeah, I'll do it then.
What, you'll relieve me like early morning? Boy.
Well, I can do it right now. I mean.
Okay. So you'll take the first night watch.
Yes.
Okay. Right.
Oh, and I have a great plan to try and trick the servant into giving away his entire guild. I could do the whole thing I can do and make myself look like the Grandmaster, then skim around happily, going, da-di-da-di-da, And that might catch him thinking, you should be half dead. Excellent plan.
Yeah, and actually, before I leave the shrine, following after the evening round, mm-hmm. I will mark down all the positions as well.
Okay. Do you have a large straw hat to cover the board?
I don't have a straw hat to cover the board, but I can note the positions.
Okay, that's fine.
Well, you could just grab a peasant to cover the board.
Peasants wiggle too much. So, it passes relatively quietly. The only thing of note is the return of your two companions.
Which I'm sure Igor is just excited by.
Hooray, you came back.
I've returned. Much to your amusement.
Now one of you take my shift.
They're done goofing off. They can do some work now.
Hey, we were doing very important stuff.
Oh yeah, you rode up and down to a town. What do you fucking do?
Road trip, and you're
road
just jealous.
Trip. Exactly. You get the hobnobbed royalty. I mean, you're stuck in a smelly, smelly town that's haunted.
Well, all I hobnobbed with was a fucking guard, so...
It's better than a fucking... That's better than the sheep heads over here.
How loud are you discussing this in the evening?
Well...
They arrive back a little bit saddle sore.
Yeah, good. I need your hat.
I need your hat, your kimono, and your horse.
You corn yours. Yeah. Where's Anasad?
Well, sure, you can have my hat. Yeah. It's going to the temple. It's a worthy cause.
Unusual.
Oh yeah, that's what's for. Okay. Right, shit in the hat.
Oh, no. I was thinking you're just going to go out back with it.
Yeah. I poop in the hat.
That's unusual hat with poop.
Right, now I've put the hat over the game board, of course, because that's a smart thing to do.
Okay.
Because that's the smart thing to do. Right, as soon as we get back, I get the innkeeper to bring our supplies in and issue strict instructions that this food may only be served to us and our two guests.
Of course, Sama.
Does he look disappointed?
He shouldn't, because he's not actually using his own fucking stock right now.
No, he doesn't seem very disappointed. A little tired, maybe. He's getting a lot more exercise than he usually does.
Cleaning up blood, stretching up mats, cleaning up hands.
Bearing people.
Actually cooking for someone.
Exactly. Well, he was cooking for the head son and his wife.
Oh yeah.
Did we ever see what he did with the hand? He didn't do anything strange with the hand, like make it into some kind of mantle.
No, the rat took the hand.
Wait, he lost the hand? I don't even know where the body is.
Guy.
I don't care.
You just came back and found the body was gone. You didn't ask.
Yeah, I don't care.
Better not to.
Has the inn started to smell a little bit?
What do you mean? No more than it already was.
That's not necessarily a good thing. I mean, this is a town in the arse end of nowhere in the mountains.
No, plain
inns, actually.
Yeah.
But yes, the rest is pretty much correct.
Oh, right, yeah, you guys should have bought some more incense, shouldn't you? Just liven up the place.
I've already used all my incense getting the shrine sorted.